Hello, ladies and gentlemen. So, what was that? Look, it's Chad, isn't it? Do you remember? It was like that, wasn't it? You're all too young. You don't remember that. Look, he's just sitting there like that, with his nose over the thing, like quite a way down, and his fingers there. And it'd always be what knows something. I think it came from the war days and things, or just after the war, I think, or in between, when there was like rationing and everyone was poor, and it's like what know potatoes, what know whatever, you know. Something like that. So where have I gone already? Come on, let's get on with it, Tel. Right, these lads have sent me down a few beers and that. It's got all lovely thing on the thing here. It's look, what's that say? Brew Hive on the them little bits there. And somewhere else, I think it says Brew Hive, but on them little box bits there. I don't want to tip it too much because I've got beers in it. And hop inside, it says. Glass, don't smash me. And dibby 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 dibby, fragile and with care and everything, and with Claire, she's a nice girl, right, and all that, but that's all good. Very nicely packaged inside, looked after, kind of, you can, the only bit I don't like is that it's got handles there, you can, the little postman can go, oh, what's in there? Now, ain't the same postman are like, naughty and they go stealing stuff and opening your envelopes or anything like that if they think, oh, this is birthday card, oh, I bet there's money in this. I ain't saying they do that, but I do. Sometimes they do seem to have opened themselves and things fall out. But look, there's a lot of postmen and there's a lot of very honest postmen, so I'm not having to go and tarring everyone with the same brush, but a few times I've lost stuff in the post. And it's accident. Oh, it got broke in the depot. Can you put a form in? Yeah, right, you know. So anyway, what have we got to read here? What's the thing? It's a little bill. It tells you some of the prices and everything else. I ain't going to kind of show everything here, but where are we? So I don't want all my order number and everything in there. So let's have a bit of that there. And a bit of that there. Give me the VAT number and everything off the top. There we go, right. There we go. And I'll show you some of the prices, because I think they're not bad prices. I don't know if you can see that now. I think they're not bad prices for all the stuff. This is contract brewed, I believe, contract brewed. And what they say, they specify what they want. I don't know if you put the orders in first, and then they get it all. But it's all pretty quickly done to you and that. And it's kind of like a little new idea where I think this is how it works. I could be wrong, hopefully they'll tell me. But, I mean, it doesn't matter to us because we just buy it. You know, they tell us what they've got or what they will have or whatever. And we buy it and put our order in and it comes to us. You know, and we get it the same amount of time and everything else. But what I think happens... Hopefully they'll tell me right. I think what they do is they say, right, this is what you can have, boys and girls. There's like a box here, blah, blah, blah. And you will be the only ones that will be able to get this. Magnificent little offer. And so you go, oh, right. No one else can get hold of these beers. I want to try them. And then they go, right, with contract brew that, I believe. And they get a brewery or two or whatever, and they package it straight up and send it out in their boxes. No messing about. All fresh, all tasty, nutritious and delicious. Got six beers in here. Hop inside. Crafted with care. And stuff like that. All cleverly boxed up. Nowhere near the edges. All safe and sound. There's a Pell Brew. This one... English Endeavour IPA, blah blah blah. It tells you what you're sniffing, but also crystal malts added for adds caramel flavour. their own labels, I believe, on them. Yep, Brew Hive and that. That's cool. On the back, what I like about this, I'll show you it first. Hold on, are you getting that? Have you got it? Have you got it? There you go, look, that sort of stuff. I like a nice informed label. I don't like it telling you what to kind of think, but I like it to be informed in it. So they've got talking points. The English Endeavour hop has a robust flavour and satisfying bitterness. So there's a little something there. It's like, ooh. And you know what hop's in there, and you kind of go, right, I'll watch out for that one. I like to be served at 11 degrees centigrade, so it's like cool, but not cold. Tasty notes, blah, blah, blah. Character, medium-bodied, fruity, and well-rounded. Compliments, chicken, fish, and salads. Well, you know, it's all good. I tend to find quite often these taste notes are a bit erroneous. But I don't know about these guys. They might really know what they're doing, I don't know. But that one's the same, so that's two of the same there. This one's a German Magnum. Ooh, it's a lager. And it's a German Magnum hop. Magnums. German Magnum hop is bold yet mild with a clean, bittering quality. I'll read these to you when I do them. I ain't going to read them all now. Can you move yours along a bit? Ooh. I've only got one more to fit in now, I believe. That one's a chocolate malt porter. I love a porter. Especially chocolate malt. That's chocolate malt as well. And that one, ooh, is an apple Irish cider. That's a good one as well. In here. Has he got no? Up there, up in the gods. There we go, just about. And that, I think, is it. Yep. There's two more in here, but they're double ups. So, let's see if I can do a quick one. Now I've spent about 10 minutes like showing you about it. Let's whack a quick one in. You've got a glass? Yep. GBBF glass. I think, I'm not sure if I saw the guys at the GBBF or not. I can't remember. Saw so many people there, trade day especially. Excuse me, wiping me head off, bloody hot. Trade day, isn't it? Cool, bloody. But, luckily I've got one behind me because I ain't prepared. I ain't got my rings on and anything else. See my belly there as I stretched. Right, so let's have a. Gonna go for the larger first. No, I'm gonna go for the IPA. For the IPA. That one with the Endeavour op. Lovely little crown, little bottle cap. And, you know, they've gone to town here. They come off very easy, though. But all the smoke and stuff, smoke's nothing. It don't really mean a lot. It just means there's carbon dioxide in there. That's all it is. When people go, ooh, smoke, ooh, and all that. If you look, sometimes you can pour it. I don't know if you get this. Nope. It's heavy in an air, so it drops down. And it's a sublimation of carbon dioxide makes the dry ice little particles in it in there that make the smoke. I don't know what it's not smoke because there's no smoke without fire. Right, Brew Hive, there he is. Right, get on with it, Tell. Stop titting around. Come on, itchy nose. Pouring out lovely. Shall I pour it for you? Look, shall I do it? Shall I do a proper one, shall I? I don't know if we're talking bulk and dish here. Can't see any yeast. So I'm pouring straight through the shoulder. There's none in the bottom, so probably not. I'm not sure. Right, that is lovely. You can pour a bit more head if you want to. You can pour it down. You can pour no head at all. You can pour massive head. It doesn't really matter. You know, you pour it from where you like. I think it's how it holds on to an head, and the head should die down nice and gradually, and it leaves them lovely dipply islands. Little dipply islands, you'll see in a minute, little dipply islands, look at them, Lord. Oh, that makes me, that's, whoo, it excites me, that does, because I think that's lovely. And you can shake it back in. Wheat beers are different. If you've got a load of wheat in a beer, even, you get wheat in there for head retention and stuff like that. But brewers, sometimes they get so frightened of losing a head that they end up reverting to things like propylene glycohalogenate and things like that. You know, you don't want that in a beer. You want a beer to be lovely and beautiful and natural. And look at that, the way it's like, it's got a head and it's dying down. Shake the head back in, what we fart on your thing. Shake the head back in if you want it, and kind of down it goes again. Anyway, shall we sniff it? And stop talking about it. It looks lovely and glorious and gorgeous. Right, sniff. It's got a lovely, lovely smell. It's not overpowering with fruits and things like that. It's got a nice, kind of almost a crossbreed smell. It's kind of got a bit of America smell to it and a bit of UK, like British smell to it. That kind of lovely English IPA, that bitterness and that earthiness, but there's nice fruits in there as well. Little resiny notes, almost a piney note in there. Peppers, things like that, and fruits. So you've got cracked white pepper, you've got a little bit of tangerine and a bit of kind of grapefruit in there. Nice little citrusy numbers. And a tiny floral little note in there, which is quite nice. Little floral kind of rose hip sort of smell to it. Right, let's dive in. I may be sometime. Cheers, everyone. Gin gin. That is really nice. Now, yeah, that is nice. Nice little oily finish to it. It's a weird little oily finish, but that's nice. I like that. Long finish on there that comes in is dry. Almost kind of like that metallic salt. You get some certain waters and that have got metallic kind of salts to them. Like, almost Andrew's liver salt sort of flavour to it, and it comes in really light and with a pungent hop and that, with a kind of bitterness hop, it comes in there and scratches the back of the tongue with a metallic, almost not bad two peas in the mouth one, you know, that you get off of some breweries and that, more usually the McLagers and things like that, but it just comes in nice, just comes in really light and grips and scratches at the tongue. And that's nice, but you've got them big fruity lumps. Just give it one more. Nice zest piff notes. The kind of like lemon almost in there. Nice little lemon notes. But nice kind of, it's a nice proper lager taste to it. Almost heading down the Pilsner road, road and that. But with kind of hops in there as well. It's kind of a cool one. I think this is one that you could convert lager boys onto, like IPAs and parallels and things like that. It's not massively hoppy, but then that's okay. It's not supposed to be massively hoppy. It's just supposed to be a bit hoppy. You know, otherwise it's a parallel if it's a bit more mild, a bit kind of more quiet. This is parallels turned up a little bit. So let's have another little spritzer of it. Nice carbonation just perks it onto the tongue. It's not too wild. It's not like, eh. I know, I just must have been the light blew me off it. I thought my tongue was yellow for a minute. I've got to get to the doctors. But yeah, really nice. Very first quenching. One's convert the lager boys and that, what I call a gateway one, gateway beer. That is lovely. Get out in the garden when you're sweating. I'm sweating not indoors, I am. But when you're out in the garden, you're doing like barbecue or you're mowing or something like that, clipping the edges and all that, you know. Clipping the edges. What with? What, an hammer? There you go. There you go. But yeah, he's snipping away at the edges and all that, and yeah, all that sort of trying to make a rude topiary. But there you go. That's nice, I like that. So cheerio Bim Bim and everything else, that's very, very nice. That is dun 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 Pal Brew. And that is from the Brew Hive English Endeavour IPA. Go out and get one. I say go out and get one. Don't go out nowhere. Stay in and get one. Phone them up. I will put the links down below. If I forget, remind me, because I've got like brain like I don't know, like a sieve. I know, I even forgot that. So down below, down here, in the like comments section, unless you're not watching on YouTube or something else, and it won't be there, it'll be somewhere else. Who knows? Just click on the link. Anyway, I shall see you in the next one, folks. Don't be late, because I will start without you. Cheerio, Bim Bim, Billy Boo. Bye. We're the man to the